What have you been up to, Tony?
Hey, Plastic, how are you?
You know, good to talk to you. I wanted to get you on the line here just to talk to you about a few things I've got coming up. What have you been doing lately? Just hanging there, practicing your bass, yeah?
I spend a lot of time now practicing. This is all you can do in this time in our lives as an entertainer, as a musician. What can you do other than practice, work on your music, and try new things? That's what we're doing. We're all trying out new, different things to reach our audiences instead of going on in a theater and you sell tickets and you do all the things you normally used to do. That doesn't work anymore. We can't do it that way. We all know that that's not going to work right now. Maybe down the road, but now we can't.
You know,
So,
with all the fans that watch my show, I love interviewing people, right? But I gotta say, see this backdrop here at the back? It's like the time tunnel. I'm going back in time, but not only that, I feel like the human dartboard.
right. I like that backdrop you've got. It's very, very crazy. If it's a little bit Austin Powery,
You see it? Hey, do you see it?
time travel,
Yeah, that's it. Get it? I'm going back in another dimension,
Yeah, I like that.
the
Yeah,
1960s.
Austin Powers time.
Yeah, now let me tell you, the reason why I got you on this video call, just you and me privately, is I got a show coming up. It's going to go live, or it's going to go in the US on the 10th of December, and I just want to show you the promo. You ready for this? That's a promo, right? It's called It's a Ripper. Plastic EP's birthday party, Plastic EP live TV worldwide. Doesn't that promo look great?
That looks great. It's a I take it that's somebody's birthday.
Yeah, that's right, it's mine. But what I did is, you got to understand something. When I interview Chachi, we got this joke going between us, and all of Massachusetts is writing in, "It's a ripper, it's a ripper." And Chachi goes to me, "What do you mean by it's a ripper?" It's a ripper is an Australian term for, like, it's great, mate. That's unreal. But what it comes from these albums, right? From the 70s. See 1976? Do you actually see it? Now, what happens is that's an actual record. And where in the world do you get a record that's got the names of the songs on a ripped pair of pants?
That is amazing.
So that's Ripper 76. Can you actually see the hits there? Do you see the songs?
Oh, Donna Summer. I can. It's hard for me to read. It's a.
I know, I know. But look at this one. That's 76. But look at this. Just as a preview, that's 77. What country in the world comes out with pictures
I see.
like that?
That's
Okay.
too cool. Too cool.
Now, I told you about the promo. Watch this. Watch this, Tony. I told you about the promo. Now, what I want you to do, Tony, if it's no trouble, want you to do an introduction so I can record it for the birthday party, right? Like, make a
This
bit
is
of a
real.
speech and maybe do a bit of a song. What do you suggest you could do?
Well, it won't be
I want
appropriate.
to see, Tony, I want to see if you pass the audition.
Yes, I think that it's only appropriate, Plastic, if I sing birthday to you.
That's a
Here
great
we go. You say it's your birthday.
Yeah, we'll do that. We'll do that. But make the speech right, because no one's watching this. It's just you and me now, right? So, what sort of a speech do you want to make?
What sort of a speech?
Yeah, what are you going to say? Plastic EP's the best. The USA loves him. He's all right.
I
I don't know
think
what you want to
one
say.
thing, let me say this. I think you're original. You're amazing. In this day of age, it's here it is, 2000, whatever, 20, pushing 21. It's here we are in 2020, and I've seen pretty much, I thought everything. We've all seen pretty much everything at our ages, And I think you're really original. And I wish you the best birthday, of course, But you're really original, and I'm coming to Australia, and I can't wait to meet you. So that'll be
Me
happening
too.
next year,
You know, and thank you for your birthday wishes. Just say happy birthday and let's go into that song, Tony.
Okay, happy birthday, Plastic EP. You say it's your birthday. It's my birthday too, yeah. You say it's your birthday. We're gonna have a good time. So glad it's your birthday. Happy birthday to you. And there you go.
Hey, thank you so much, Tony. You could always get work doing weddings.
There you go, mate. There you go. And we're using our microphones in the little speaker here. So
we're looking great, aren't we? You know what I feel like? I feel like I'm talking to Paul in his office. Oh, I'm not joking.
Thank you very much.
Imagine you meeting Paul. And they did a video.
You come on to me, then I'll come on to you.
I mean, you know what I suggest? I suggest the people at MPL, that's his company, isn't it?
Yeah, MPL, yeah.
Right, in London, in Soho. Yeah. That they give you a ring, right? But I'll be your manager. I'll cut the deal for you, right? What happens is, so we have a video of one desk and you two talking to each other on the phone. Oh, I reckon that would be unreal.
I've always wanted to meet him. He's seen me perform. He's made comments about me. I know he's seen me on television somewhere in London, probably in England, you know. And it was nice to hear that he gave me nice compliments. You know, the guy that plays me in Beatlemania is a talented musician, and I wish him well. And he said that basically about all the group members in our group, you know, at the time. And it was nice to hear that. And, you know, another guy was George Martin, who really was wonderful to meet. He saw my show. He watched every minute of the show for a couple of hours, came backstage and told me that I did a great job. And it's so nice to hear that from a guy that made the Beatles records. So that gives you a lot of inspiration, you know, when you're moving on and you're doing your thing. It makes you feel good, you know.
Tony, let me do you a favor now. Let me handle it, right? Because you were so kind enough to do that for It's a Ripper, Plastic EP's birthday party. I'm going to do you a favor. You just have your coffee. Let me talk. So Paul McCartney, if you're out there and you happen to be wandering on the net and you see me, Plastic EP, and Tony Kishman, right, who's been performing forever, doing you, singing your songs, please contact me or Tony on Messenger. We'll believe it's you, right? We know there's 10,000 imitators out there, but when you text us, just use the code name. What code name should he use?
Plastic EP. Code name.
No. He can use one of his. I reckon come up with one of his songs, right? Like, listen to what the man says. Just send me a text.
We would
use the handle.
I say we give him the code C-Moon.
C-Moon, yeah, all right. So C-Moon. When I get a text and it says C-Moon, right?
Yeah.
I'll know that it's you, that's your handle.
We'll know it's him, C-Moon.
We'll know it's you. Make no mistake. And then what we'll do is we can organize an interview. Well, you'll fly us out for free to London, right? And Tony and I will sit at a desk and we'll film it, and it'll be funnier than anything you've seen on the net. So, Paul, when you've got nothing to do, just remember us. We're true fans. Is that good, Tony, or what?
I think so. And, it's funny. I've always been a fan of Paul McCartney's, not because I portray him or play his music so much. Of course, I can appreciate it probably more than most, being that I'm this close to his music, but I've always just admired him as a Beatle and what he's done to the world. He changed the world. I mean, most musicians make hit records and they're successful, and they're like Led Zeppelin and Journey and all the groups, Queen. They have an amazing effect on the world, but the Beatles changed the world. And so you kind of have to hand it to the guy. And it was his birthday just yesterday.
I was going
to
say that.
Yeah.
You just beat me to the punch.
It was his birthday yesterday. And I watched a 50-song countdown they started at number 50 to number one of songs that people loved of Paul McCartney's. A lot of them we do in the show. And the funny thing was, is that, you know, that was only the tip of the iceberg of what this man has written. You know, it's just unreal. So, but I wanted to mention, Plastic, that you were asking me, what am I doing lately? Well, we're going to try something different. We're going to do an interactive live stream of one of my concerts that we did at the Agua Caliente in Rancho Mirage. And it's a 12-piece orchestra behind me with my 4-piece band, phenomenal musicians, and we're going to do a live interactive stream on June 24th. So I was going to invite people to see it. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm going to be coming in and out of the video, kind of like, you know, this. I'll be in and I'll be doing some songs and things and talking about some pretty interesting things about the show and about my past. So it's going to be on Facebook, obviously, and it'll be on June 24th at 4 p.m. West Coast U.S. time. So, you know, Pacific Coast time at 4 p.m., 7 p.m. in the East Coast.
Well, let me surprise you, Tony.
What time would it be there?
I search the net every day, and guess what I found? That's it there, isn't it? How great do you look there? Seriously, yeah. How great. Hang on, I'll give you a free plug. Where's my finger? Where am I? Hang on. I got to find myself. Hang on.
There it is. Hey.
I don't know which way it is. It's really bad.
You got to come.
Yeah, that's it. I got to say, you look like Paul there. Now, I found that promo, and I stuck it on my pages yesterday. How great a friend is that?
You're the man. I'm telling you, you're a sweetheart for that. I appreciate it.
But come in the little square a little bit more, please. Just
this one here?
Yeah, stick your face there. And please, I'm reading the promo, right? Okay. Everyone out there in the world, Live and Let Die, the music of Paul McCartney, online concert performance, June the 24th, 4 p.m. Pacific. Is that right? Pacific time?
Yeah, Pacific time, 4 p.m. And then 7 p.m.
Eastern time.
Yeah.
Tickets, $10. Where do they get the tickets from?
Well, they go online and they just look, you know, it's just follow the dots, really.
Yeah, www.performance.
That's it. Yeah, go to performancetonight.com and then just follow the prompts. Yeah.
I can't see through these glasses.
Uh-huh.
I don't see nothing.
It's pretty easy to find, you know.
It's really bad. You know what's really bad?
What's that?
Because if I wake up at 4 a.m., hey, a big shout out from Mitch Wiseman. Come on.
Yeah, Mitch. Hey, how you doing, Mitch?
Mitch, we love you, Mitch. I need you to give me a birthday hello. I've got to get you on for 5 minutes. Can you do me a favor, Mitch? Just get your iPhone and just film your beautiful face and just say, happy birthday, Plastic EP, and send it to me like Charles Rosenay. Because he sent me a beautiful one near the pool. And he's actually on too, Charles. Tony, yes, looking and sounding great as always. Look at that. We've got real friends there.
Hey, Plastic, you know, the funny thing with Mitch, he was the first Paul McCartney, you know, basically impersonator, whatever you want to call it, for Beatlemania. He was the original guy. When I first joined Beatlemania, Mitch had already... You know, he was already on stage doing shows. So my story was I was in Los Angeles and the show was running already at the Schubert Theater. And I remember going to the Schubert Theater and I was already hired in the show. I had gone through a series of auditions and I finally got the job, you know, that kind of thing. And I was all excited. And it was really a big time show, big Broadway show. It was fun. And I got to meet Mitch, of course, you know. So I went to the Schubert Theater in Los Angeles, and I walked into up to the stage, and I look over, and I'm saying, this guy looks like Paul McCartney. I got to check this guy out, you know. So I was thinking, well, you know, he may not look that much like him or whatever. But anyway, he's on stage, and he's playing a sound check, right? And he turns over to the right, and he looks – at me, right? And I'm standing on the side of the stage. He looks at me, and I looked at him, and I went, holy shit, this guy looks like McCartney. So I thought I was really impressed, you know. And we've always been good friends. Whenever I've seen Mitch, it's been great. I mean, I don't see him very often, of course. But I wish him well, and I, you know, like anything, I hope all the best for him. You know, it's been years since we've seen each other, but anyway, that was a pretty cool thing, seeing him for the first time in person. You know,
but you know what? We might get you on the second time. Might be me, Charles, yeah. Charles Rosene, Mitch. They might, you know, I reckon the best thing is they come on and the four of us be on.
Oh, that'd be
and
fun.
I reckon that'd be fun. You know what? If they hang in there, Tony. If you hang in there, I'm gonna send them a link now and see if they come on now. I'm serious. I'm gonna try. All right. Just wait. Dude. I'll see if I can get them on. You keep talking to everyone about your show. I'm gonna try and get them on now live. See if they come on. All right, keep talking.
Okay, so in the meantime, I'm gonna tell you more about our live stream we're doing. So the video was recorded in, like I said, in the Agua Caliente, beautiful arena type venue. And we did a really great concert there. And it's going to be really nice to share with people because they can see what kind of show we do. It's a lot of people wonder, what do you do with an orchestra? How do you perform these songs and so forth? And this will give you a taste of what it's like. Plus, what we're going to do is have some of the band members talk about their role in the show as well. Because it's not just me up in front of a show, a band. It's guys that are really well-seasoned players that are just amazing people. Like, for example, Tommy Williams is in the band. He's doing guitar, playing lead guitar, vocals. Chris Holt is doing lead guitar, rhythm guitar, bass guitar, and piano. And singing, and then Brad Swigger on drums, Keith Hill on keyboards, and our conductor, Martin Herman, is back there conducting the orchestra. So these guys are the top-notch players. I'm proud to know them and to be able to perform with them on stage. And we bring this music to life. It's just a great, great show. So this is our way of kind of keeping the Live and Let Die theme alive without performing live, but it is a live performance. So with all that being said, you'll be able to see what we do on June 24th at 4 and 7 p.m., depending on where you live in the U.S. And it's a lot of fun. It'll be fun. We'll be talking. We'll be coming in and out of the video. And I think you'll like it.
That's fantastic. Yeah. But now, as I said, how much preparation do you do? Do you do for each show?
Well, we do our with anymore. What we do is we decide what's going to be in the show, what songs are going to be in the show. Usually, I do that depending on what we feel is the time factor. How many minutes do they want? Are we going to do an intermission or not? So we pick the songs that we know people probably need to hear, right? And then there's the songs people want to hear, and then there's the people. Then there's the songs people would like to hear. So I like to do some sort of album cuts, if you will, some deeper cuts. But we do a lot of the big hits. You have to sing Yesterday. You have to do Let It Be, Hey Jude. We do those. But then we also do some nice deeper cuts, which people, bands don't play live because they don't have an orchestra handy on stage. Or they... You know, the band sometimes can't perform it. So we have a very, very strong band. So we can do songs like Uncle Albert or we do the song Live and Let Die with a full orchestra, you know. So it's a really nice thing to hear all of the parts that are played on the record, note for note, the same as it is recorded. And this is how we prepare the show. And then, of course, we do a great sound check. We do a rehearsal. We have to rehearse the orchestra from top to bottom before the show. And then we do the show. So that's how we prepare for, and that's how we did this show at the Agua. we did a full rehearsal before the show, and then we went right in and did the show. So it was great. And we filmed it, which is good. And who knew that today would be the day we would air, well, not today, but now in this world of today, that we would do something like this, a live stream, you know, interactive. So that's what we're going to do.
That's amazing. Now, listen, get your bass and play me a bit of your Paul McCartney song, and we'll see who comes on this happy birthday segment. Play me something.
Happy birthday.
Play anything you like. But listen, if you had to sing a song to Paul, what song would you sing it for his birthday? That's fair.
Speed along the highway. Honey, I want it my way. But listen to her daddy's song. Don't stay out too long. Ooh, we're just busy hiding. Sitting in the back seat of my car. I would do something like that.
You know what is one of my favorite songs? I don't know if you can do it right, but Big Red Barn has always been one of my favorite songs.
Oh, man. And, you know, that's my wife's favorite song. And we,
can you do it or you can't?
You know, I wish I knew that one. I wish I knew that one. But those are the kind of album cuts that we're starting to dabble into because we want to broaden the spectrum of the song list. You know, and people are, you know what? People have heard, you know, the main Beatles songs. There's been Beatle bands on every street corner playing. Oh, yeah. Tell you something. You know, everybody plays the song. I Want to Hold Your Hand and She Loves You and Help and all these songs. But what we're trying to do is feature Paul McCartney's solo material and what a genius the man is. I mean, think about it. He did songs that were so incredible, like Backseat of My Car, you know. And we try to do stuff like that. We're dabbling more into more deeper cuts, you know, and not the usual 10 songs that you would go see a band do, you know. So that's what I think.
What are you drinking, Tony?
Coffee. Hey, I gotta have my coffee, you know.
Come on, I'm waiting for two people to come on if they come on. But while we're waiting, just play something.
Yeah.
No, that's another Beatles song. Keep it rolling. Gotta keep this show rolling while we're waiting for these VIP guests to turn up if they come.
Let's see. Let's see. See, now it's first day of summer here.
Yeah.
And when I was in Arizona, this bass would never go out of tune, ever, ever, ever. Okay. But here on the East Coast, you got this humidity going deep. It's really strong. And it really does play havoc on guitars, you know.
Oh, it cracks the wood, does it?
It really does. It's funny. I find myself tuning more often than I normally would. You know what I'm saying? And I just went ahead and did this guitar.
Right.
Every night I just want to go out, get out of my head. Every day I don't want to get up, get out of my bed. Every night I want to play out. And every day I want to do, but tonight I just want to stay and be with you, and be with you. Mama,
Tony, that was fantastic. But I got to tell you, you know what people don't understand, right? If I open my mouth and I sing with you, there's this latency, right?
Right.
It's like
right,
a 2-second delay. So people are so kind and they say, can you sing with me? And I'm thinking to myself, you don't want to. Like, Ron Dainty started singing and I started singing with him. And I knew.
There's a delay and then you're going, wait, but what's that?
And I didn't want to wreck the song. That's what it is. But you know when you play the guitar?
Yeah.
Because you go through a computer, like even there, the sound hits the little mic and you can't hear it. Even though you think you're playing all right, if you play softly, I'll give you an example.
Okay.
Can you play Red Barn? I don't know if you can, right? You know, it goes, who's that coming round the corner? Who's that coming round the bend? I love that song. Can you play it? But play the guitar very softly and you'll see. I know what I'm talking about. Everyone's going to hear it.
How about this?
Please.
Is that better?
Yeah. Keep going.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to arise. Is that better?
Yeah, of course.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free.
Well done. You know, I got a selection of any of those songs for my birthday show now. I'm going to take whatever I want. If I want to put two together, I'm going to do that because it sounded great. But let me tell you, are you happy to take the Plastic EP song test?
I don't know. You're going to have to give me a shot at it. Yeah, give me a shot at it.
No, you have to tell me because this is our work. I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to ask you to do.
Okay.
But I just want to ask you, Tony Kishman, are you prepared to take the Plastic EP song?
Yes.
Song selection?
Yes, I'll try me.
Right, okay. I need you to play... And not too loud. One song from the Please Please Me album. Now that could be I Saw Her Standing There. You know the songs.
Well.
That could be Please Please Me. That could be Ask Me Why, PS I Love You. Do I have to go through the songs with you?
You know something? You've got me stumped. Because then have to
play. A song from the album. Can you play a song from the album?
We have to give me song titles.
Twist and Shout, Ask Me Why.
Yeah, keep going.
Hang on. Oh, good.
I've got
the albums. Yeah, I couldn't be bothered getting them. What I'll do is we're going to do this. I'll just type in the albums, right? And you can pick a song. It's not a problem.
Yeah.
You know Twist and Shout, though, don't you? You know I Saw Her Standing There.
I do.
All right, do you want to play a little bit of I Saw Her Standing There? Here, look, I'll go through the songs. Here we go. You got to pick the songs that mean something to you. Okay, so I call them, and then you say stop, and that's the song you do, all right?
Okay.
Here we go. I Saw Her Standing There. Misery. Anna Go To Him. Chains. Boys. Ask Me Why.
Uh-huh.
Please Please Me. Love Me Do. P.S. I Love You. We're running out of songs here, Tony.
Keep going.
Baby, it's you. The idea is you got to tell me stop. You want to know a secret? Hurry up, that's your last chance.
You want to know a secret?
I taste the honey. Huh? You got to say stop. There's a place. This is the last song now.
Go ahead.
Twist and Shout. Are you going to do Twist and Shout? Do you understand what you got to do?
Well, you know,
you got to stop me on the song. I can't go past the song. And then we can't.
Here's
we
the
can't go back.
Here's the thing. I could sit here and grab one of these bass guitars and play several of those, right?
Okay.
But it's just going to be me banging on a bass.
Yeah, that's okay. Can you just play a bit of one of the songs?
Can I plug one in?
Of course. Take it down. I've got it all night.
Try it.
Make sure your guitars and bass don't fall around there, you know?
Let's see what we got. You said, let's see here.
The first album's all right, but when we play the second album, I'm going to say names, and you have to say stop. If I go past the name, you've lost that choice. Do you get it?
So you for
the
said,
first album, you
go ahead. Say I'll play a song after you say the words.
No, I'll explain. You must choose one song from every album. So when I mention the name, the title, if I say I saw her standing there and you don't say nothing, and then I say the word misery, you can't do I saw her standing there. Do you understand?
Right. Okay.
It's like a spinning wheel. When I go past the number, you can't go back. So we'll start again, and you have to say stop, and I stop, and that's the song you do. Got it?
Okay.
Go again. You got the rules now.
Yeah.
All right? I'm going through the Police Please album. First thing you say, stop, and that's the song you have to do. And if I mention all the songs, the 14 or 12, and you haven't done it, you lose.
Okay, go ahead.
All right. I saw her standing there.
Stop.
There you go.
Well, she was just 17. You know what I mean. And the way she looked was way beyond compare. So how could I dance with another? Woo, not saw her standing there. And there you go.
That's unreal. You pass. Now, because you're in America, you guys had Meet the Beatles. So we had With the Beatles.
Yes.
So now here we go again. Let's see how you go. Tell me stop, because otherwise we're going to keep going. All right.
Go ahead.
These are easy. I want to hold your hand. I saw her standing there. That's the eliminator. We did it. This boy, it won't be long. All I got to do. I bet you go for this one. All my loving.
All my loving. Stop.
Right.
And I'll kiss you tomorrow. I'll miss you. Remember, I'll always be true. And then while I'm away, I'll ride home every day, and I'll send all my love to you. That's it.
That's it. You know what? You passed the test. I don't have to do anymore. But let me tell you something that's going to surprise you.
Yeah.
I discovered a group, and I want you to check them out. And they're called the New Piccadillys.
Yeah.
All right? Now, they do a song. I think it's called Total Control. And George Kaiser has spent 3 years making puppets of the band in a little recording studio. It's like the Thunderbirds.
Yeah.
So every model is made. The recording studio's made as models. The drummer's a model. Everything's a model. Three years to make that video. It is the most unbelievable video you have ever seen in your life. And if I was Brian Epstein, it's 1964, and there was no Beatles, he's got the Beatles sound. The most amazing thing I've ever seen and heard in my life. You hear it first from me. I've done the interview with George Kaiser. Go to Plastic EP Live TV and make sure you see it. And the puppets that he makes, unbelievable. He did. Little Richard. He was working on Little Richard. Little Richard passed away.
Wow.
He's done Jerry Lee Lewis. He's done Johnny Cash as puppets now recently. Huh. Have a look at his puppets. It's mind-blowing.
Jeez.
But the sound of the band, the New Piccadillys, I've never seen or heard anything like it in my life.
Wow.
It's like, you know something that no one knows, and that's why I tell everybody, go on the net, look up Total Control by the New Piccadillys. You'll see a video that you've never seen. And not only that, they did a Ramones song too. They did a cover version of one of the Ramones songs. It's wow. really good too. Is that amazing or what?
That is, you know, and it's funny because at this time in our lives, I mean, isn't it the weirdest thing? I mean, you wake up, you go out, you do things, you got a mask on, you got to do everything with a mask. I just recently flew across the United States recently, and I had a mask on the whole time, you know, so nobody recognized me, you know, but I had a mask on. And, you know, it's like everybody had a mask. You don't see faces. You don't see people talking. If you smile at somebody, they don't know you're smiling. You know, like if I'm doing this and you can't see me and I'm looking at you and I can open my eyes and I close my eyes, you don't know if I'm crazy or whatever, you know. And it's a really sad thing to see all of us musicians, all of the singers in the world, all of the bands, all of the tribute artists, all of the recording artists, you know, nobody can go out and play in front of people right now. And if you do, you're going to have a selected thing, like we're going to do a drive-in theater type thing. Have you got drive-ins in Melbourne?
We've got a few now. There's two remaining. There's one in a suburb called Coburg, and there's one in Dromana. They're the last two drive-in theaters that are here. Right.
And, you know, the people that contacted me with doing a drive-in, it's a great thing because we'll be able to still perform in front of at least cars, you know.
Of course.
And, but there'll be people in the cars, and they'll be able to maybe sit out in the front of their cars in a chair, but there'll be distance. But as far as doing shows in a theater, it's going to be really a long time before that happens. Now, we are scheduled to do shows in September and October, November, December. You know, we're doing scheduling, but, you know, everybody's hopeful. You know, they're hopeful because so that's why right now we're all kind of sitting back saying, well, let's try to interact with people, you know, in the world. So I'm saying this, that anyone that's out there that may have ever seen my show or are curious to see my show, I'd love for them to tune in, you know, and see a little bit what it's like, you know. And it'll be doing the good of the people that are on the stage and us. We'll feel good that they tuned in, you know.
But this is gonna be amazing, as I said. And the promo you've done there.
Yeah, my wife.
Great. They did a great job.
You know, my wife Bree does amazing artwork like that. She's
great. She does.
Good, you know, she's technical, man. She knows how to do that.
I know. Look at me. That looks like a home job. They've done it.
I like it. You know what? It's got personality. I like it. You know, if you ever want her to do something for you in that, you know, in that genre of stuff, just let me know. She's
kind, Tony. Anyway, we're waiting for our two guests. It looks like they've been held up. Doing other things. Because you understand sometimes it's very short notice. I like doing things spontaneous. I know, like instant. I love instant. People want interviews and they think I've got to do research for 3 hours. I don't. They've got to be prepared to come on so that when we do it, bang, it's done. And that's the kind of interview I love. I love, like, I'll tell you something now. Charles Rosener, I love interviewing the guy. He's a live wire. And let me tell you, this is what I love about Mitch, all right? This is the great guy that Mitch is. I'll tell you why. We're doing an interview and we organized the time.
Yeah.
Mitch came on and he did the interview, but he was kind enough then to start talking about Kiss. And I said, Mitch, can we do another interview on Kiss? And he goes, sure, no problem. So as soon as we finished one, he gave me the second interview and told me fascinating things about his time with Kiss.
Oh, wow.
Things that you won't even know.
That's so cool. Yeah, I know. I think he worked with Kiss. Yeah. That's really cool.
He wrote songs with them too.
Yeah. Yeah, he did.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
He's an amazing man, an amazing artist, amazing person. We're all amazing. Even Charles Rosner is amazing too. I don't know what to say now. It looks like we're going to have to end this great
thank you
time that we had together. And isn't it funny how we went live when we thought we weren't live, Tony?
Yes, I think that's great. And you know what I wanted to say is that for any of those people out there that want to see us at the drive-in theater,
oh, yeah.
July 11th in Perry, New York, at the Charcoal Corral, I believe it is. They have a drive-in, big, giant drive-in thing where we're going to be performing full, big, full stage live. And then people can come in and they'll tune in on their radios of the sound that's coming off the stage. Plus, they'll hear the sound coming off the stage if they're out of their car. So that's going to be at the Charcoal Corral on July 11th at, I believe, a 7 p.m. start.
That's so, like American Graffiti.
Huh?
It's like the movie American Graffiti.
Oh, yeah. It'll be so different.
You'll be rocking up in your hot rod, yeah?
Yeah. But it's awesome, Plastic. Well, listen, you know, you stay well, mate, and thank you for having me on as always, man. This is really, really fun, and I appreciate it as always.
No, I just want to say thank you, Tony, for coming on. Doing that pre-recorded birthday special that's coming up on the 10th of July for everyone in the US. Even I'm excited. I can't wait. I've already got Charles Rosenay's video. He sent it to me. I have to talk to him because maybe we might be able to release that before the date because I can't give it too much away.
Sure.
But I'll tell you a little bit of a secret. He's giving me his birthday cheers while he's by the pool. That was really great. No one knows what I've seen. No one knows. All right, Tony. We're going to give it a wrap. As I said, good luck with your online concert.
Thank you.
And I've got enough footage now for the birthday show from you. I'll probably put two songs together because it's
cool.
You know, it's really good. And you know what? What is it? Today's Sunday in Melbourne, so it's Saturday for you there. Is that right?
Saturday night here at 7:14.
And what do you normally do on a Saturday night? Watch a movie?
We're going to have
a little CD. What do you do?
No, we're going to have a late dinner, and we're here in Rome, New York. That's where I'm living now, Rome. And we're going to kind of wind down and have a nice evening. And I feel really great that I got to talk to you. And, we're doing what we're doing, and we're waiting and hoping that the world will heal. I mean, that's
okay. Can I ask you, is Rome, New York? Tell me this. Is that near Little Italy?
No. No, but it's near Syracuse.
Yeah, but Syracuse. My wife's got relatives near Syracuse.
Yeah, it's right near Syracuse.
And Rochester. They're in Rochester. Yeah. How far is that from there?
Yeah.
Mo, are you there?
Yes, I'm right near Rochester and Syracuse.
Because we've got relatives. So if you ever come to Rochester, how far are we away from where you are?
I'm about 2 hours from Rochester, but an hour from Syracuse.
All right, that's great. When you see two donkeys coming down the street and my wife and I riding them, you know we've arrived, all right? But I'll give you prior notice, but I also got to tell you a story.
Yeah.
Okay. This is a place to keep a story. I love telling my stories. Anyway, my wife and I, we go to New York, and we're going to go visit the relatives in Rochester. And they own a restaurant. So anyway, we get a plane from New York to, I think you land in Rochester. Is that where it lands?
Syracuse is the closest airport.
Okay, well, we landed there. And anyway, we went and saw the relatives, and now I've got relatives in Canada, Ontario, in Kitchener. So we organized that they're going to drive and meet us in Buffalo, and the relative from Rochester is going to drive us to Buffalo to the casino there. I don't know if you know it.
I don't.
Okay, no. There's a casino there. Anyway, what happens is...
What's the name of the casino again?
I don't know the name. I don't remember. All I know is I've got photos. So here's the big family reunion.
Casino, hold on. I do. The Niagara Seneca. Niagara Seneca?
Probably. It's like round. It's like a bit round. It's got big car parks all around it. Anyway, I think that's the place. Anyway, we got the big family meeting.
I played the Seneca. I don't know.
All right. Me and my wife rock up with a relative that's kind enough to drive us from Rochester. So yeah. How far is Rochester from Buffalo?
It's like an hour and a half, maybe. Something like that.
Because we would have caught the bus. But the relative offered to drive us, right? So here we are. We're going to the hotel, the casino in Buffalo. I've never been there in my life, right? So here's the relatives waiting for us from Kitchener, Ontario, right? Canada, yeah. They came across the border with their passports. We meet up. We have something to eat. And then they take us back now. We say goodbye to the people of Rochester. See ya. We're going up to the border now to cross to Canada. And before we get there, my relative says, you got to buy some beer. And I said, yeah. He goes, because it's cheap. I go, all right. Since we're staying at your house, no problem. Just give us a ring. Somebody. I've got an interview happening here. Don't worry about the birthday celebration. I'll talk to you in a minute.
With Tony, what's wrong with that?
You're still talking. How do you close this? Seriously. He's ringing again. Sorry, man. That's getting funny. Hang on, I've got to close my phone. This is a joke. Anyway, so he's ringing again. I know a lot of people here in Melbourne. You got no idea how they behave, Tony, okay?
Well, we gotta do this again soon.
Yeah, we are. Anyway, I just cut the short story. The story's short. Anyway, I said, let's buy some beer. And I said, sure. We're staying at your place for a week. Buy whatever you want. So he's happy as Larry. And then his car's full of beer. We cross the border. We drive past Niagara Falls. My wife sticks to me. And he goes, do you want to see Niagara Falls? And as we're driving right across the road, I can see all the water spraying out from the road. And I go, no, that's fine. Just keep driving.
Jesus. Oh, God.
Do you know what I did, Tony? This is my last thing. You know Hard Rock Cafe?
Yeah.
I collect the T-shirts from Hard Rock Cafes all over the world. My cupboard is full of Hard Rock T-shirts. Because what I do is I buy a certain T-shirt. I've got to tell them. We're talking. We're going to hear an hour soon. Don't worry. Anyway, what happens is, it's got the logo. It says Hard Rock T-shirt, Hard Rock Cafe.
Right.
And on the back, it's got a picture. I only buy the one that's got the picture. So it says San Francisco. It's got the bridge. And it's got the guitars. Then there's Niagara Falls ones. I bought that one too. Then I got like Boston. There's another one where it's got a statue on the back. I love these T-shirts. Have you got one?
I have several of them, yeah. I do. I love them. The Hard Rock T-shirts.
Tony Kishman, been my pleasure. Cannot thank you enough, brother. Just stay there. Thank you, everybody, from all over the world for watching this. And I'll let you know. I'll let him know a little secret. The start of the show, it looked like we didn't know what we were doing. But let me tell you, it was rehearsed.
That's why you have an edit button. There you go.
All right. See you, everybody. Love you. Bye.
Take care, buddy. Bye-bye.
Yeah, just stay there for a minute, Tony. All right. Thank